सर कैलाश चंद्रा, एक्सरसाइज नंबर 516 एंड द डिक्टेशन स्पीड इज 100 वर्ड्स पर मिनट। रेडी स्टार्ट। सर द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर रीड आउट द होल लिस्ट ऑफ स्कीम्स विच द गवर्नमेंट हैड बीन इंट्रोड्यूसिंग लाइक द रूरल वर्क्स स्कीम, क्रैश प्रोग्राम्स, हाफ अ मिलियन जॉब्स स्कीम एंड द होल प्लेथोरा ऑफ स्कीम्स, बट ही हैज डेलिबरेटली कंसील्ड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग, नेमली डिस्पाइट ऑल दीज एफर्ट्स बाय द गवर्नमेंट, अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट हैज बीन कंटिन्यूअसली राइजिंग एवर सिंस द फर्स्ट 5 ईयर प्लान। इफ इन द बिगनिंग ऑफ द फर्स्ट 5 ईयर प्लान अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट टोटल्ड 33 लैक्स, नाउ इट इज एनीवेयर नियर 400 लैक्स, प्लस 30% ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन हु आर इन अ स्टेट ऑफ डिसगाइज्ड अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट। अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट प्रॉब्लम इज कंटिन्यूअसली गेटिंग एग्रावेटेड डिस्पाइट ऑल द क्रैश प्रोग्राम्स, डिस्पाइट ऑल द रूरल वर्क्स प्रोग्राम्स दैट हैव बीन अंडरटेकन सो फार। आई एम टेम्प्टेड टू से दिस बिकॉज द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर हैज डेलिबरेटली यूज्ड द डिटेल्स ऑफ द वेरियस स्कीम्स ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ओनली टू कंसील द मेन पॉइंट दैट द गवर्नमेंट हैज अटरली फेल्ड टू सॉल्व द problem of unemployment. Whatever they have done has been a drop in the ocean, and the unemployment problem continues to be aggravated. You may be putting a few crores of rupees here and there in the name of solving unemployment problem, but in fact whatever money you have put in the unemployment schemes has been frittered away by private hungry contractors and political workers of the ruling party at the local level. They have been misusing the funds rather than creating assets. I would like the Honorable Minister, for example, to tell the House out of the total investments you have made for the crash programs, for the rural walks programs. How much percentage of the total outlay has been spent on reproducible assets? Government will not be able to give the figures because, like the figures for unemployment, government refuses to collect figures regarding reproducible assets. How much of the total outlay for employment schemes has been spent on reproducible assets creating employment of a permanent nature? In fact, a large proportion of the money has been spent on investments which create only temporary jobs, and the mandates that have been added to the total employment figures are only temporary in nature, even if they are real. Mr. Vice Chairman, sir, the Honorable Minister said that the proposal of the mover of this bill, namely in case government is unable to provide employment, it is duty bound to pay unemployment allowance, cannot be accepted. The main reason put forward by the Honorable Minister is that investment should be used in productive schemes and not for giving doles. That was one of his arguments. He said that because of the resource position, the government could not utilize their limited resources for unemployment allowance because the implications would be too large. large amounts of money will be needed for such a scheme. He also said in his characteristic fashion that if unemployment allowance is given, it will add to the inflationary pressure. I fail to understand his logic because unemployment allowance can add to inflationary pressure only in a situation where such resources have been created by deficit financing or in a situation where unemployment allowance is given without commensurate development activity. It is true that in a period of inflation, in a period of economic stagnation, as we are having today, any disbursement of money from deficit financing will add to inflation. The mover of the motion or anybody else did not demand such an allowance to be distributed. We demand that while the economic crisis should be solved by changing the economic policies of the government is duty bound to give unemployment allowance in case the government fails to provide gainful employment to the people, particularly the working people. The Honorable Minister spent a lot of time in enumerating the steps that government have taken. For example, the Bhagwati Committee's interim report was submitted earlier, an interim ministerial group report was submitted, and the final report was submitted in May 1993. Then another interministerial group was formed by the Planning Commission. They deliberated and submitted a report after a number of years. Interim reports, final reports, interministerial groups reports and reports galore, but no action. Why is that? Despite the Dantwala committee's recommendations, concrete figures have not been collected regarding unemployment, because the government knows that if the practice of making estimate of our unemployment, which was there till the end of the third plan, was continued, people would rise in revolt, because this government is incapable of providing gainful employment. Plan after plan, year after year, the additional labor force coming to the labor market has been much larger than the additional employment generated by all the crash programs and special programs taken together. Let the minister have the courage to contradict me. Is the minister prepared to assert that the new jobs created every year are equal to or more than the additional labor force? He would not be able to say that.